jump right into it. My name is Key. If you don't know already, make sure to click that subscribe button down below if you haven't, a thumbs up. And yeah, let's get into it. So I'm going to be showing you how I do my wash and go routine. This is my third time, I want to say, having my natural hair out. I'm not used to having my natural hair out, so I really don't know what I'd be doing. But first off, I'm just using a paddle brush to go ahead and take out my kinks, because I did have my hair braided up. For all of you naturalistas that don't think you should be using a towel, I'm using a towel. I'm not about to put on, take no shirt and use the shirt on camera. I'm going to use my towel. So I'm starting off with my Dove Intense Repairing shampoo, and then I do use the Brazilian Keratin conditioner because I like those two mixed together. So right now I'm just using the Ion Reconstructor, and this right here is the goat in helping my hair to get it back in order. Usually after I take my braids out, as you can see my curls, they're really not defined, but that is what that reconstructor does. It's a protein treatment, so it helps give my hair back the moisture and my curls be so freaking defined, like really on point. So as you see my curls, and then when I turn to the other side, they're kind of like sticking together. So this right here just really what helps my hair look really bomb when I do a wash and go. So you can see now how defined my curls are after I have washed that treatment out. And you do only want to leave it in for 10 minutes. So now I'm going on my Teagan Green Tea Super Moisturizer. This is something that my mama put me on to because she has curly hair. After I put this in my hair, it made my curls pop so freaking much. Like, I need to go get all Teagan stuff. But this part is going to be very repetitious. I'm going to keep doing the same stuff over and over. I kind of do like the lock method. So I did use my leave-in conditioner first. Now I'm going on to my oils. So I do use the black castor oil. And then I'm using the olive oil treatment that I leave in as well. Then I'm going to be using my Cantu. This is the moisturizing curl cream. Just go ahead and define my curls a little bit more, and then I am using the Shea Moisture curl stretch pudding, and this is just to help your curls from not stretching. After this time, I usually put like two ponytails in my hair to kind of help it stretch, because I like to let my hair air dry. But since I am going to be putting in clip-ins, this is how my hair is going to look. And I should have showed y'all how long my hair was, like stretched it out a little bit, if so that you can see it. But yeah, that is how my hair looks. So now we're going to go into the clip-ins. I am using the Outre Big Beautiful Hair Clip-ins. It is in the style 4C Coily Fro, and it is the natural brown. You do get 9 clip-ins. I think I use all but one of the clip-ins. And it's just showing you on the back, you know, before and after. This color is a natural brown. You can see the difference because my hair, I should have got a natural black, but they didn't have that in stock. So you could see a difference up close, but far away you're not gonna be able to tell between the color. So I did use the 12 inch to start out with, and as you can see, it looks so freaking bomb. And these clip-ins are synthetic. When you get them, the ends are going to be like a little bit frayed, not frayed, but what is the word, frizzy. They're going to be frizzy on the ends, and so they're not as defined as you would, you know, they're not defined, so they really look like really, really natural. And I like that because, you know, the ends of natural hair is not defined. Is not defined whatsoever. And I don't know my natural hair texture, but it kind of mimics this one because I know I do got coily hair, but I don't know between the 4Cs and Bs and all that. But this mimics my hair so freaking well, you cannot tell the difference in between my hair. So I'm just taking my fingers and parting my hair, because if you got curly hair, you, that comb, baby, is serious business. I'm not about to use no comb. So my parts look all kind of funny ways, but long as some clip-ins are in, that's all that matters. So really, you just push the clip in and put the clip in your hair, and then you just bend it, really. So that is how the clip-ins look. Like I said, Where's my hair? Where's the clip-ins? You can't tell, and neither can I. So after that, I am taking a Nairobi Foaming Wrap mousse just to kind of get the ends to blend in. They look blended in to me. I just want to do something extra. So this step, I don't think it really matters, to be honest. I'm just doing something just to do something. And then I just want to frame the side of the face. Girl, I don't know why I was doing that, because I forgot that my hair was out. But this right here is the final result. My camera did die, so now I'm on my actual camera setup, my vlogging camera. So if you like, want to see more clip-in videos from me or my natural hair and me doing styles, just let me know in the down any comments, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.